Say good morning, Hulk. That's dope. I gotta take this really big shit right now. Dude, I really gotta take this big shit. You need it? Alright. I'll say hi to everybody in a minute. I gotta take this down. He's the greatest dog, I'm telling you. I have no idea. Every morning. Dude, come on. I gotta change this stuff. Let me out. Come on. Stop playing around. Let me out alone, too. No puppies. They're gonna annoy me. I gotta poop.
So good morning, everybody. We are cooking breakfast. We're not cooking breakfast, we're cleaning up. Breakfast is on the way. And we have one of our sponsors is coming out here today, Big Dog Chains, coming out to fit some of the dogs into some collars because we got some video shoots coming up and some photo shoots. It's a nice, bright, sunny day. So, waiting for them, it should be here in a couple hours. Then we're going to take some pictures. I'm going to see how much I can integrate this and get this camera involved. So we'll see what that's like. So hopefully it ends up in this blog. But I've been watching other people's blogs, vlogs. I know everybody's mad at me over this, what I call it. But, you know, as long as you understand me, I don't really care. But vlog, whatever. So I've been watching some other people's channels and just kind of getting an idea. You know what I mean? I don't know, like, what you put in it. You guys are surprised, so you're like, you just film everything. Yeah, just film everything. I don't want to bore the crap out of you guys, you know what I mean? So it's like, I don't want to just have like 20 minutes of like the same thing. So, you know, I'm just trying to get a couple ideas of what we're filming, so that's what I'm doing. Right now, you got me pacing back and forth in my hallway. Because I'm hungry and my food's not here yet. I really have some computer work to do, but it's kind of hot in here. So I think I'm going to open the window. But I'm just looking at these mountains right now, like thinking, man, I wish my drone wasn't down right now. I'd be on this. I'd be filming some videos flying through the crowd, through the clouds. But right now, the drone is down. But anyways, we have some fun today. See some dogs, about to go on some little couple walks. I think I gotta charge this thing. This is awkward. Yeah, Lisa's here. Wow, she waved to you guys. Oh, who's here? Hercules is here too. He's like, dude, I'm out, dude. These guys want to be on camera.
They were chewing on your candle.
They were, you were what?
I say no.
Little Sarah, you were eating my sandals?
Both of them were.
What do you do? You guys are playing tug of my sandals. I know your little bump head there. I know he got stung by something. He's got a little swell, little bump head. These two and little mommy. Sorry, my kitchen's terribly dirty, so you get to see me. But I think I gotta charge this, so I'm gonna come back. But I told you what we got on deck for the day, so it should be fun. Do blog number 3. I'm telling you, I'm serious. These blogs are gonna be coming, consistently coming, until you guys tell me your blogs suck. Stop making them. So until then, they're coming. Keep watching them, keep sharing them. Appreciate you guys. So hopefully we can bring you some entertainment from kind of like behind the scenes type stuff. Just kind of, you know, what we're doing. Oh, I hear saw. Derek's outside making the face to my new office decoration over here that I'll show you guys when it's finished. So I'm gonna charge this and see you guys in a few. Are you barking at my door? Are you all done? You guys got it's dirty. Are you barking at my door, big guy? What are you trying to tell me? I'm done. I need to come in. So
So, as funny as it is, you know, I love the narrative from my dogs. As you'll see it and watch these vlogs, I'm constantly putting words in their mouth. But from a dog teacher perspective, when a dog tells you he needs to come inside and barks at you, to instantly let him inside is counterproductive. But it is cute and funny that he's out there. Just, you know, it goes along with the storyline. But I just want to be very clear that for dog training purposes, this would be counterproductive if you were to let the dog in when he barks. But it's cute for the dog. Dude, you need to come in. Dad, dude, I already did my dog. I need to come in now. Dude, see, everybody else says so too. I see you there, pal. Okay? All right. Still gonna give him just a minute to settle down. I'm gonna open up the door. I see you, okay? I see you, bub. I see it. You say hi to your family. Okay, you say hi to everybody. All right. I'm gonna close the door. I need to be quiet. I'm gonna let you in. All right? All right. He's mad at me. All right, that was a little short of a duration than we needed, but all right, let's go.
Dude, come on, go ahead. Go ahead up the stairs.
I want to say hi to my dad, bro. My dad is right there. Come on, go ahead. Go on, go. Go ahead, dude, go on. Look at this sweat, look at this guy. Dude, I know you're so hot. I'd like to go to my AC room right now, please. This Hulk in his movie theater. Gotta put his water in there because he's in my office. A lot of the puppies are in here. This dog's coming up and down. But during the day, like when it gets hotter, Hulk, he has a room with the AC. Him and Cassius are in there a lot. Just chilling, staying extra cool. When I work dogs, sometimes, you know, I'll bring them in and put them in that room just so they can cool off. Because out where I live in the mountains, like, it really doesn't get that hot. So we don't really use AC like that. Like, I don't, you know, like, I'm cool with the temperature. It's not, like, it doesn't really get disgusting. Maybe a couple days out of the year, it gets pretty hot. But I go outside, lay down in the lake for a little while. I'm cool, man. You know, living in the mountains is beautiful. So, but that's what Hulk's doing, man. But that dude, man, I'm telling you, like, as you watch these vlogs, I hope you just can really start to see more of him, because he's just... Like the little clips that I show you, everything that I show you is so real, and that's what you'll see, is like, he's just such an animated, like, happy character, you know? And I actually have this amazing idea for him that I'm not gonna, like, say is in development or anything, but I just had this crazy idea after seeing this old show that I used to watch. And I gotta talk to some people about this, because I think I might be on the gold with what this dog should be doing. So, man, you just got me thinking about that. It's crazy. But he's such an old soul. He's just such a peaceful, like, happy. He's always happy. You know, like, anytime I'm down, I swear, just open the door. This dude just, hey, yeah. You know, just happy, ready to go do whatever, you know. So, you know, he's just wonderful. He's just a wonderful dog. It's beautiful. That's what I do this for, dogs. It's just, they're just such incredible, incredible specimens. They've taught me so many things. They've made me into who I am today. You know, so I'm just so truly, truly blessed to live this life that I live with these dogs every day and get to spend every day with these dogs. And travel the world, you know, with these dogs and just doing what we love, you know, educating people, teaching people. That's what this is about, you know. So all the content, everything that's coming out, you know, follow along, listen closely, because we're strong believers in change, but we're strong believers in change the right way. Now, I don't want to, like, hurt anybody's feelings, but, you know, I always say I got 150 acres of land here. I could plop down, like, you know, 40 buildings and bang out, like, a million dogs. Like, I could rescue a million dogs. I didn't even make a dent in the problem. You know, like, realistically, I'm not changing anything, you know, by doing that. You know, it's been happening for years. Tons and tons of money has went through this. Like, and again, I'm not trying to say anything negative about this problem. You got to understand where I'm coming from. My idea of how I can change and help change what's going on in the world with how people view dogs in general is, you know, to really get it in here for people. So the more and more, you know, worldwide we go, you know, from the television show working on to the books, you know, to everything that's coming to these blogs, to the YouTube, to the Facebook, you know, all the educational things that we can teach you, you know, about, you know, ownership of dogs, and, you know, it's about leadership and, you know, responsibility, and, you know, that's what it's about, you know. It's a lot of time, you know, misunderstanding is where a lot of these issues come from, you know. People, you so many times and none, like, I've been in a situation where I've been like, oh my God, what is this person thinking with this dog? Like, what are they doing? And I actually go into it and I learn a little bit of the person and like their background and where they come from, and you realize that, you know, it's not common sense isn't really a fair phrase, because everybody comes from different backgrounds. They just don't understand what's going on. As soon as you brought them the education and you bring it to them a way that they can understand it, you know, you compare it to something in their life and make it in a way that they can understand, you know, then I believe that spreads and that goes through millions and millions of people. You know, I can't even tell you how many people, you know, approach us and come up to us and are like, you know, I used to be afraid of dogs and I saw these videos and I saw this dog, and, you know, that's what it's all about. You know, people are intaking this way of life, because it only works if you embrace it fully, and that's something that I really want to be very clear on. You know, if you think you're gonna live this life, you know, dog psychology, the dog free, you know, everything, all the freedom, everything that you see here, dogs all together all the time, but you're only gonna embrace part of it, like, oh, you know, I do certain things right and not the rest of the things, it's not gonna work. You really have to embrace this philosophy full bore for it to work, otherwise you won't see the change. And I'm telling you, man, if you embrace it, these dogs can change your life. They have the power to uplift you to a level that you never knew you could get on. And I'm telling you, dogs are the most amazing thing on earth. And, you know, like I said before, I'm truly, truly blessed to just have this be my job. And I love all you guys. Like I always say, I truly do. Love me or hate me, you really, if, you know, maybe you're not business minded, but, you know, for business, you know, negativity and the negative things you guys say makes things bigger as well. You know, so I always appreciate that. And anytime that happens, you know, I mean, it is what it is. Sometimes things get personal, but, you know, you gotta have thick skin to be in this position. And, you know, I really don't, at this point, I don't see a lot, I don't read through a lot, I don't get to see anything, so it really doesn't even matter for me. I just stay focused on doing what I'm doing. You know, I love the people that love me, I love the people that hate me, and, you know, just intake one day at a time, man. And I'm just happy I got roof over my head, air in my lungs, my family is healthy, you know, everybody is good and everything is good. And, you know, that's how I like to keep it. Lots of complication in life, but, you know, everything in life only matters as much as you let it, you know. So this is probably a long piece, but, you know, I feel like, you know, these are important things for people to hear. Yeah, I don't know if you guys know or have seen, but all you YouTube goers, if you haven't looked at these 360 video cameras, go look at them. That is so crazy, and I'm going to have to get one. So, I can't wait to see what the hell we can do with that. That's going to be crazy. So, we got a couple things right now that are clearing up, coming to an end, and I'm going to have one of those things on the way to my house, maybe two, to see what we can do with them. Because I've never seen anything like that. I can't imagine what it'd be like to see, like, a dog, you know, come in or put it on the dog. I mean, it just would be, that's just crazy. Right now I'm in my, in the little workshop, the little converted greenhouse here. Derek's in here working on the face of the office decorations here. So it's supposed to be white, but Home Depot decided to not have any white, so we just changed the color, so that's fine. It'll still work. It's got one clean, smooth side, but this guy's in here trying to fix the drill. Cigarette hanging out of the mouth. We're gonna teach this dude about health as we go along. Y'all gonna help me, man. Y'all gonna help me. We just gonna start bitching a lot. So, back out here in the back, just pop back through. This is like the nature. I don't know if I was talking about it yesterday. I don't know what the hell I talked about yesterday, but I think I'm gonna put together some from yesterday and some today in this blog. But over there, I'm not gonna walk all over there because I got sandals, but there's a stream and like there's a lot of rocks. And I actually have, there's a piece that's actually already set in there. That's part of part of the catwalks that go through there for the dogs to walk on. And there's Ace's wall without the rug on it that we put on the front. We just did this the other day. This is This is the imprinting pen. Oh, there goes some dogs on a walk here. I think we got, who we got, let's see. Who we got, he's coming. Alright, we got Blade and Belle. There go Mark on a walk. So, stuff going on. Lisa's inside getting ready. Like I said, today we got a sponsor coming over. So this is the little imprinting pen that we just started. So basically, it's closed off. So like they got us there. They're in there, basically. We got the little tunnel going on. They climb up here and it just slides down. You know, I just like to throw a lot of just different surfaces and different things they can see. And then there's actually going to be a ladder in the back corner that comes up, and there's a catwalk that goes across the top, so the dogs learn how to walk on the top of that. That back side is cut out so the dogs can actually jump in, have an entry point into, which is going to be a pit that's full of bottles and boxes and, you know, different things that make a lot of noise. So that's what we got going on here. So that's one of the things that we got to finish up, because we got a sponsor coming. We'll probably all be focused on photo shoot and getting certain things done and hammered out. But hopefully we have, we'll be working on that again. We'll have that totally finished by tomorrow. So I got to unload some couple things that I need to go inside with, and I got to finish up some paperwork real quick. We out here right now just checking out these beautiful collection chains here. We're gonna do a photo shoot with Hulk. Look at that one. Nice gold on that. Look at that. This is the Maui.
Got some floral design.
Yep, for all you ladies out there. There you go.
And we got the Magnum.
Yep. See that one? This one's got a little nice design. Nice small tight.
That's the big boy. This is the Caesar. Cuban Link. This is the big boy.
Look at the size of that guy right there. Oh, come here, boy. Come here. Show him. Come here.
Yeah, okay.
I got mine on. Look at, you want to be cool like me? You want to look like him? Better hit up Big Dog Chains. It's getting real. It's coming out soon. Check them out on Facebook and Instagram. You guys got a YouTube?
Not yet,
YouTubers. They'll be YouTubing soon. You know, world's YouTubing now. We were just talking about how strange it is that all you guys just, this little $200 camera, this little like light thing that feels like a little like, just the lightest little camera in the world brings you all this entertainment. It's amazing. So we'll keep it going. So this is what we got going on right now. We're just checking out all the nice collars here, and then we're gonna get them on Hulk, take some pictures. Lisa just abandoned us. So,
they're not recommended for people, but if you really want to get tied up and leashed up, we can.
if you're feeling like you want to get super gangster,
that might be a new market for me, actually, the BDSM crowd, you know?
They're Canadian, don't mind them. Yeah. So, this is what we're doing. I think we're gonna go and snap a couple pictures real quick. I'm gonna figure out how I got this little cool little tripod all mounted onto whatever we got near us, and you guys will stick with us. But let me tell you, this whole vlogging thing is super weird. But I'll get used to it.
Trial and error.
Yeah, you know, trial and error. Everybody's out there blogging. I spent my night last night like looking at blogs. They're like, I'm like, what do people blog about? You know, like, yeah, and these guys are getting millions and millions and millions of views. People just watching people, like, the most random stuff. So, you know, we'll keep it random for you guys.
Still on the link, man. This guy's big.
Hey! See that in the water? There you go.
Water with him at the other spot. Oh,
top. We're gonna get in a picture of her, a solid picture of her with the chain on. Hulk Mama. So these guys, they've been to get a picture with the ball, and then Mark Huggins threw the ball by accident, and the dog went in between Derek's legs and almost took him out.
That would have been a good vlog.
That would have been a sweet vlog.
Let's reenact that. Do it again.
See, the thing is, filming reality, they'd make you do it again. They'd be oh, do it again. You do it again. Like, no, that's
like,
why reality's not
like,
reality.
Like, how is it reality? Like, do you have lines on there? Like,
they must set up some situations.
I could give you the inside of reality TV from the top to the bottom. But yeah, the scenarios are set. So like, for me to film it, like, I know the five stories that are... show is being filmed about. You know what I mean? So it's like, I don't know what's gonna happen on that day in terms of like events that are gonna occur, things are gonna happen, but I know like they'll have a game plan. Like they wanna come in and they wanna film this part, then they wanna film this part, then they wanna film this, then they gotta get all the B-roll, you know, and they'll have certain things that they want you to say. Like you have to say it a certain way or say this, say that. Reality is not so much real. It is and it isn't, you know? Where it's like, it's not like,
I guess compared to what else is on TV, it's pretty real.
They don't just come and, like this camera is filmed, they don't just come and just film you. Like, they don't just come and just film everything that's going on. There's a plan. There's a plan, there's an agenda. There's always a plan. You know what I mean? So it's not necessarily reality.
Where's that going to fit? That's not
going to fit. I don't know if this is necessarily working how I planned it, so I might have to take her down to the back down there, to the grass where he's tall enough to get it.
I gotta get a selfie stick.
Back away, we're a little close for me.
Me or him?
Both of you. The whole experience. There we go. There we go.
I'm glad you got some good cameras because I was not equipped for a photo shoot here.
Alright. Go ahead, get out. Give it to me. What's up, guys? This camera is dying all the time, so I didn't charge it last night, but hopefully I don't just shoot up. But we out here right now, they on the video. We got one on video shoot. We're just doing a photo shoot today. So we got spotters everywhere, camera. Here's Blade with his big dog chain on. Look at that. Let's go be interruptive. So you ask how we do this with dogs, dogs that are trained, a lot easier to take pictures with. Sometimes you're asking for the dog to be doing something different, depending on the situation. Right now, he just wanted to stand just like that still, so he can get a side angle of the collar, which you can see now. We're here right now. Sue's got his bling on. Go make sure you check these guys out right here. Big dog chain. See this? Look at that. You want your dog to bling like that, you got to see this man right here. He's the only man on earth that's making these right now. So
that's right.
Make sure you check that out, YouTube guys. My phone's ringing in my pocket. I wonder who the hell it is. Talk to you later. It's crazy. I never answer the phone. Oh, what we got going on? We got action. Missed it. Got Lisa over there reviewing photos. I'm telling you guys, blogging is weird, but I'm getting the hang of it. Just film random stuff. Dude, there's no cigarette in this guy's mouth. There's something wrong. Am I in the background, like totally killing the shot?
No, because by the time he gets there, I can't see the collar anymore.
So we're just stacking pictures.
Even the smaller ones holding up to the big boys.
Hey, see that? Hear that?
Yep. That's a smaller version. That's the Magnum collar. One of the smaller, but it's still strong. Don't let the size deceive you.
That's what it's all about. Strength. Durability testing. See that right there? There you go, man. There's the link right there. Go check that out. Oh, Lisa blocked it.
Wait here.
Got Mark, one of our new trainers here. Busy. But you know, it's some fun, you know, it's some fun. I hope you guys are enjoying these vlogs. You know, they're a little weird for me, but I'll keep saying that until it's not weird. As soon as it's not weird, you hear me stop saying that it's weird. But for now, it's weird. I'm used to the production angle of it.
Celebrity, man, you gotta get used to it, man. That's how it goes.
We're working on it, man. It's new for me to know that you guys just want to be in my life for like 20 uncut minutes. Well, they're kind of cut, but you know, just 20 minutes. So we're getting used to it.
I want
to
see the best of you, man.
Jump in. Yeah, they're super cute.
Yeah, they're so cute. Alright, guys. I was doing this. Why you gotta do that? That was not that. Why you gotta be like that?
There's the Malinois for you.
You want a fucking Malinois?